In the 19th century, it was meant as a curse to say to others, "May live in interesting times." Here today in the 21st century, our class could not be experiencing a more fitting example of what this expression means. In the past few months, we've been through a lot. We've had political divides, natural disasters, and now a pandemic and civil unrest. The world is on fire figuratively and counting climate change literally. It's a tough time for all of us, but it's important to remember that out of every fire, a phoenix rises out of the ashes. And I believe that we, the class of 2020, are that phoenix. Despite everything that's happened, we're still here for graduation day, and I wanted to say congratulations to all of you, my fellow classmates. I feel proud of us. Although we may be distanced during this time, we are not alone, and we never have been. Over the course of our education, we have all met those we can call classmates, friends, and teachers who believe in us and encourage us to pursue our dreams, and in the end, find the success we want out of life. And as we leave high school behind, that support will continue and be the helpful guiding light we need to push forward in any dark times ahead. None of us planned for this, but our class has risen to the challenge and continue to hold our heads high. I cannot tell you how lucky I feel to be part of such an amazing group of people. It is mind-boggling to think about how this is only the beginning of our lives. Already through these 18 years of our lives, we've experienced so much emotion, such as happiness, sadness, anger, though I feel pride for all of our accomplishments. But once again, this is just the beginning. We should not look ahead fearful of the struggles that will await us, but instead look forward to all of the joy and progress that will be made, the progress I know our class will contribute to. After all these years of preparation, it is finally the time for us to step off into the world and help. I know that wherever you go, you will go on to be successful and make us all proud. Thank you all for an experience that will never be forgotten. We live in interesting times now, and we will go on to rise above and forge a peaceful future. Thank you, and good luck to all challengers.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I want to thank you for the wonderful experience that you have shared and the memories you have left behind. As you venture into your future, just remember, this is one chapter of many that will be written of your life. So as you turn your attention to the next chapter, please continue to be courageous, take chances, and never stop making your dreams become reality. Again, congratulations on the chapter.
It is with great honor that I introduce Mervyn M. Dymally's 2020 Salutatorian Juliet Cruz.
Hello, family, friends, faculty, and graduating class of 2020. My name is Juliet Cruz, Mervyn M. Dymally's Salutatorian. Before I begin, I want to admit I am very saddened with how our senior year in high school was impacted. I was upset at all things we lost, prom, grad night, senior activities, and all our moments together. The fact that we cannot be together right now in this moment still stings. There will never be the right words to say that'll make up for the things we lost. But enough of the things we cannot change. Let's look forward to the things that we will change. We made it, class of 2020. We have accomplished so much. We're closing this huge chapter of our life that started just 4 years ago. When I think about freshman year, I can't help but laugh at how much we all changed. We were so awkward and new. It was so funny. We were all ready for this new chapter. Freshman year. The year we met new friends, some remain with us today. I met my best friends, Aaliyah and Pacheco, in ninth grade. They have bettered my life in so many ways. All the laughs, moments, and tears we cried freshman year will definitely be one for the books, because learning Korean was no piece of cake, and having Ms. Smith for science was definitely no walk at the park. Sophomore year, feels like it was so long ago. I remember every emotion I felt that year, where some of us even met our match, Ms. David's math class. The amount of tough love she gave was oddly just right, though. Sophomore year, I also joined my first sports team, and the bonds I created were amazing. Shout out to the volleyball girls. I love you guys. Junior year. Boom, that was a tough one, without a doubt. All the studying and testing we endured, what an insane year. But guess what? We made it. We did that. And the best part, we did it together. Even in times of adversity, I learned that life won't always go as planned. But as challengers, we learn from it, and we rise above it. Then came our year, the year we look forward to desperately. Honestly, I think about it like this. Us, as the class of 2020, we were too powerful. There was just no way our year could have gone as planned. Everything was just so perfect. Our first year with football, an undefeated girls volleyball season, winning CIF championship in boys basketball, all the incredible experiences together. Everything was just so right. But our journey doesn't end here. I promise it doesn't. The world awaits. I have so much love for Dymally. I have this emotional attachment to our school because of all the wonderful people I have met. Dymally teachers and staff, you all definitely have a spot in my heart. You shaped me not only to a student, but as a woman. The experiences I will cherish forever. I learned that I'm worth it. We are worth it. We had an unprecedented senior year, but we will not let the negative define us. We will not focus on what we lost. Instead, we will focus on what is ahead. Adversity will not define us. How we respond to it will. We don't give up easily. We don't take no for an answer. We will keep our head held high as we navigate through our lives. We will never forget the memories we made here. We will never forget about those that supported us in our journey. We don't know what the future holds, but I know we are in this together. We are game changers. We are the Dymally class of 2020. We will become great. I have no doubt about us and our abilities. We have so much to offer to this world. I see so much greatness in each of us. Again, thank you to our teachers, staff, counselors, admin, coaches, friends, and family. Thank you to everyone that was a part of the Dymally family. So here we are, poised for the next steps, ready to lean into our new responsibilities as young adults. I've never been one for goodbyes, so I won't say it. Instead, I'll see you all later. I promise this isn't the last of Juliet Cruz you'll see. Dymally class of 2020, be proud of all your accomplishments. We are positioned to be changed. Remember, challengers, you can accomplish anything you put your mind to do. We will dream big. We will take chances. We will succeed. I love you all. Don't forget about me. Don't forget about us. We connected as graduates of this great class. Congratulations, class of 2020. And remember, you are a Dymally challenger forever.
Good afternoon, Dymally challengers. I'm Dr. Dion Brady, assistant principal at Dymally High School. To the Challenger class of 2020, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate you on all of your successes and this monumental accomplishment. We salute your resiliency and perseverance during this time. Forever, your class will be linked to the COVID-19 pandemic of 2020, and that's okay. However, as you close this chapter in your book of life, reflect on the positive and good things that happened throughout your years at Dymally, and especially this year, including a football season, a traditional homecoming, and a city championship. Understand that regardless of the situation, our expectations for you remain high. We expect you to go out into the world and make a difference. We are currently in some challenging times right now, but it will be up to you to make the change that needs to happen. We salute you and we congratulate you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
On this emotional day, I say congratulations, class of 2020. We will now have McCarr J. Pugh, your senior class president.
Good afternoon, challengers. On this day, June 12th, we officially become high school graduates. For those who don't know me, my name is McCarr J. and I was a senior class president. I've had the pleasure of attending Dymally for the last 4 years, and I can honestly say it has been a roller coaster, especially our senior year. I've had the pleasure of meeting great teachers and staff who have helped me become the young woman we see here right now. So I just want to say that I am grateful to the teachers and staff who have helped me and pushed me to become a leader and a hard worker. We're going to be able to venture outside of our comfort zones and grow to be amazing and successful people. Some of us have known each other since middle school, some of us just been in the last 4 years, but even if I didn't know you, I can honestly say we are one big family. We've met our best friends, our sisters, and brothers. It's amazing how much life can change. We're all together celebrating at school spirit, at games and events. I can see future business owners, fashion icons and directors, and so much more. I know most of us are always saying we'll never use this in the real life, but after all the college applications and financial aid, I can honestly say it was very useful. For the past year, we have gone through some tough times, but have gained a knowledge knowing everything with us. And being here on this day, looking at all the graduates of the class of 2020, even if I didn't know you, I am glad to say that I am proud of you. I am glad to say that you made a graduate and you worked hard for this and will work. Some of us may never see each other again. Some of us will. Some of us go off to college and some won't. But at the end of the day, you still have these last 4 years of high school to look back on and reminisce. I am glad to say I went to Dymally. I am glad to say that I am and will always be the graduate of the class of 2020. So goodbye, my future leaders. It has been a pleasure, and I cannot wait to see you after again. Have a great day and congratulations.
Good afternoon. It is my esteemed pleasure to stand here today to witness the graduation of the Mervyn M. Dymally High School class of 2020. Being here with you and watching as you complete one chapter in your life and begin another one brings me a great sense of pride and hope in knowing that you are the next generation that will continue to bring positive changes here. We're just so grateful. After the novelty of graduation wears off, however, I want you to think long and hard about your future and the things that you can do to bring about change here. President Barack Obama once said, "Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones that we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek." These words ring even more true today than ever. And reach out for you. You are the change that we want to see. All of you here have the potential to do so much individually as well as collectively. So with that, I want to congratulate the dynamic Dymally class of 2020 for your hard work and accomplishments. But remember, this is only the beginning. As a member of our Dymally family, we're counting on you to bring about the positive change here that we need in our community and possibly even on a grander scale.
Hello, graduating class of 2020. I would like to introduce a great student to represent the class of 2020. Please vote, Hennessy Harper.
My name is Hennessy. I would like to start off by recognizing all the parents and families that have joined to be a part of this next chapter of our lives. I would also like to thank all the teachers throughout our lives that has helped us never given up on us and gave us the proper guidance to be successful in life. It has been quite a ride for us. Give yourself a round of applause. You've made it. As I look at all of you today, I wanted to tell you how proud I am of every single one of you. It feels as though freshman year was yesterday. I know, freshman year was probably one of the most embarrassing years of our lives, but also the scariest. Most of us were shy and still trying to figure out who should we hang out with and who should we date. It felt like high school was going to last forever. Then soon enough, sophomore year came around and we were no longer the newbies. We felt like we were more experienced because we understood our schedule to get to class, knew where to sit at lunch, and knew who to buy chips from. The junior year came and we were all ready for school just to end. We felt like we'd been in school forever. Junior year was one of the hardest years. As soon as I thought I was going to get a hang of everything, bam, SATs came. And then the biggest question we all had to ask ourselves, what are we going to do after high school? Go to college or work? I still remember the last day of junior year. I was excited to be a senior. I felt as though this year was going to be my year. But little did we all know, there was a different plan in store for us. This pandemic hit us by surprise. None of us were prepared nor thought it was going to be this serious. I know a lot of you were affected by the fact that we aren't going to have a prom or senior activities and graduation. But you all never given up. You made sure you logged in Schoology and joined those Zoom classes and stayed hopeful. I believe this pandemic and movement had made us one of the strongest class by pushing us through heartache, adversity, uncertainty, and fear. We faced it, we conquered it, and we came out on top. You should all be proud to say that I am the class of 2020. Congratulations, my fellow classmates. I wish you all the best on your future endeavors. You will always and forever be a Dymally chapter.
Hello, everyone. I would like to introduce the voice of Dymally, Aaliyah Farias.
In the 10th grade, the Los Angeles Times wrote an article about what it meant to be a kid from South Central. Even then, they didn't get a fraction of what it actually meant. So what does it mean to be a Black or Brown student from South Central? What that means is unique to everyone. But one thing is certain, we are challengers. We still manage to get to school every day, even after there were shootings near our homes, even after our aunts and uncles were killed, even after seeing our loved ones struggle. But why? Why did we still choose to come to school every day, even after these traumatic events? For some, it was because there was no food at home. For others, it was because staying at home was worse than coming to school. It doesn't matter what the reason was for you coming to school, because in the end, you came. And now you're here, graduating. And you may not feel it now because of the circumstances, but you will feel it later. I need you to know that you will determine what happens within the next 100 years. Whatever path you take now will determine what happens in America. Don't let future generations grow up dying to gang violence, with their parents being deported, with family members being murdered to white supremacy. Don't let that be their future. Do something. Our people need help. And the only people that will fight for us are the people that look like us. Take the steps now to change our community. Set the life you wish you had. So now, with more meaning than I have ever said, Dymally Challengers, remember, you are worthy. You are someone. You are the only version of you to exist in the universe. You are great. You are special. You are a Dymally Challenger.
Hello, Dymally family. I would like to introduce the next student speaker, La voz de Dymally, Marilyn Vittoria.
Good afternoon, family, friends, teachers, and staff. I'm honored to be here celebrating the memories and accomplishment of the great class of 2020. Now, I know some of you might not know me, so allow me to introduce myself. I am Marilyn Vittoria, Vittoria with an F, not Victoria. But anyways, I want to give a big congratulations to everyone for being here, including myself, because a high school diploma is very important. The work that we currently live at the moment can be scary, especially having COVID-19 on the top of any social issues, such as global warming, acne, Zoom classes. But despite all the odds, we still managed to graduate. Class of 2020, our future might not be clear here or now, but we all have a vision to become the best version of ourselves. If we can take anything from our high school experience, is that we are believers, believers that anything is possible, because we are Dymally Challengers. I am a proud ELD student who is graduating and going to college. What makes me even prouder is that I'm not the only one. I wouldn't be able to achieve this if it wasn't for our school, our teachers, my parents, and lastly, you guys. It might sound corny, but each and every one of you guys have been here and helped me to become the person that I am today. Our class has been through a lot and makes me realize how diligent and resilient we are. I want to give a message to every ELD student. A high school diploma can open many doors for us, and we should never stop dreaming. I see ourselves at the top, making a difference in this world, because we have seen how enduring and resilient this world can be. We won't give up until we see a change in the front of our aspirations. As my speech comes to the end, along with my senior year of high school, I wanted to share a quote by Charles Dickens. It was the best of time, it was the worst of time. And we most definitely had a roller coaster over a school year. We might not experience a normal senior year as a loss of possible memories, such as grad night, prom, even our own graduation. But something we haven't lost is our hope. We will continue to have fighting spirit, and we will continue to reach our goals. Dymally students, remember, we are believers. We're all in this together. Once we know that we are, we'll start. And we've seen that we're all in this together. And it shows that we stand hand in hand, make our dreams come true. Class of 2020, congratulations.
Hello, I'm Councilman Curran Price, and I want to wish congratulations to the Dymally High School graduating class of 2020, along with the challengers. First of all, I want to recognize the hard work of the teachers, administrative staff, and the unwavering leadership of Principal Gardena Bradley. We've had the privilege of working closely with your school as part of job fairs, neighborhood cleanups, and other community efforts designed to uplift South LA. It's my greatest honor to share this defining moment in your lives, and in fact, all of our lives. We never could have imagined a time that we're living in now, in the midst of a global pandemic. But you've already set a shining example to everyone around you and for generations to come. Each of you has faced challenges far greater than most have had to endure in earning an education. And even though you are hard-pressed on all sides, you are not crushed. You might have been troubled, but far from being destroyed. In a time when the world stopped, you kept going. These attributes will carry you far on life's journey, one that's already been filled with endless possibilities. I wholeheartedly believe that many of you graduating today have the ideas and solutions our district, the city, and the world needs. So ask yourself, how do your dreams shape your future and the future of our community? Continue to listen to your hearts, and if you listen close enough, it will tell you the right answers. Go after the dreams that set your soul on fire. Embrace the opportunities and even the setbacks that come your way. And when faced with any obstacle, you can look back at 2020 knowing that you have what it takes to get through anything. We also want to thank the mothers, fathers, siblings, loved ones, friends, and neighbors who always believed in your abilities to succeed. Again, on behalf of Council District 9, we want to wish congratulations to the class of 2020. And finally, let me say this to you. On October 15th, 1951, I was working in a Korean defense plant during the Korean conflict. And the foreman came to me and said, "Dymally, do you play baseball?" I said, "No, I play cricket." He said, "No, I'm talking about baseball." I said, "Why?" He said, "Three strikes in baseball and you're out. You have two. One more, you're gone." October 15th, 1951. That was my Emancipation Day. I came to the conclusion, and I spread this word to students. In America, as a minority, there's no substitute for hard work and education. You work hard, you get an education, it will pay off eventually.
Join us in celebrating our students' hard work with this presentation of awards. Earning our Superintendent's Honor Roll Awards are Andrea Lopez, Aliyah Farias, Juliet Cruz, and Javier Chavez Martinez. High Honor Awards are given to students who have earned an overall 3.5 GPA or higher. El premio de altos honores se le dan a estudiantes que se han ganado un promedio de 3.5 o más en sus calificaciones. Jen Baños, Javier Chavez Martinez, Griselda Martín, Catherine Alas Alemán, Jesús Bautista, Juliet Cruz, Aliyah Farias, Andrea Lopez, and Angel Sorto. Students receiving honor awards have earned a GPA of 3.0 through 3.49. Estudiantes recibiendo honores son estudiantes que han ganado un promedio de 3.0 a 3.49 en sus clases. Stephanie Arroyo, Marisol Barreto, Peter Barrios Alvarado, Luis Hurtado, Kevin Mancia Arteaga, Luis Mejia, Alexis Moreno, Genesis Otero, Darlene Pacheco Aguilar, Mokar J. Pugh, Leslie Reyes, Kathy Rojo Flores, Catherine Salas, Victoriano Alvarez, Nakaya Colefield. Alondra Fernandez, Ana Fijar, Marilyn Victoria Aguilar, Oscar Fuentes Benavides, Mónica García Guevara, Yesenia Hernández, Arlene Iturriaga, Evelyn Juárez, Kelby Marín, Madeline Murillo, Dulce Torres, Alejandro Pacheco, Marilyn Ramos Sigüenza, Jacqueline Ramos, Maylee Robertson Perkins, Catherine Romo Montes. Students who've earned the Golden State Merit Scholar Award have done so by meeting qualifying criteria in multiple content areas, such as history, English, math, and science. Marisol Barreto, Javier Chavez Marin, Luis Hurtado, Griselda Martin, Luis Montes, Heriberto Vázquez Razo, Catherine Alas Aleman, Jesus Bautista. Additionally, Nakaya Cofield, Juliet Cruz, Aliyah Farias, Ana Fijar, Madeline Pitoria Aguilar, Oscar Fuentes Benavides, Monica Garcia Guevara, Arlene Utriaga, Evelyn Juarez, Andrea Lopez, Marilyn Ramos Sigüenza, Maylee Robertson Perkins, Catherine Romo Montes, and Angel Sorto have all earned the Golden State Merit Scholar Award. Students earning the Seal of Biliteracy Award have demonstrated proficiency in both English and Spanish based on courses, GPA, state and or advanced placement exams. Victoriano Alvarez, Reggie Diaz, Alondra Fernandez, Catherine Alas Alemán, Oscar Fuentes Benavides, Arlene Iturriaga, Anthony Javier, Andrea López, Marilyn Ramos Sigüenza, Catherine Romo Montes, and Dulce Torres. The following students have earned a Persistence Award: Viviana Vieira, Essence Ray, Darlene Pacheco Aguilar, Marlene Mendoza, Dalia Guerrero, Jose Gomez, Allison Gomez, and Diego Garcia Negrete. Persistence Awards were also earned by Julian Lopez Chavez, Corian Barnes, Rosemary Chavez, Martin Cardenas, Juan Bats Semet, Jen Baños, Jezebel Alvarado.
At this time, we will begin the awarding of diplomas. Graduating seniors, please stand.
Andrea Lopez, Class of 2020 Valedictorian, Superintendent's Honor Roll, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD, and California Seal of Biliteracy. Juliet Cruz, Class of 2020 Salutatorian, Superintendent's Honor Roll, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Cheer, Varsity Volleyball, Varsity Softball.
Javier Chavez Martinez, Superintendent's Honor Roll, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar.
Aliyah Farias, Superintendent's Honor Roll, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Softball, Varsity Volleyball, Varsity Cross Country, the voice of Dymally's morning announcements. Catherine Alas Aleman, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy.
Griselda Martin, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar. Jen Baños, High Honors, Persistence Award.
Angel Sorto, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar. Jesus Bautista, High Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar. Marilyn Fetoria Aguilar, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, La Voz de los Anuncios por la Mañana de Dymally. Monica Garcia Guevara, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Volleyball. Oscar Fuentes Benavides, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy. Catherine Romo Montes, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy. Evelyn Juarez, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Basketball. Maylee Robertson Perkins, Senior Class Treasurer, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar. Madeline Murillo, Honors, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy.
Stephanie Arroyo, Honors.
Anna Fihad, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Cross Country.
Alexis Moreno, Honors, Varsity Softball, Varsity Volleyball.
Yesenia Hernandez, Honors.
Genesis Otero, Honors. Darlene Pacheco Aguilar, Honors, Persistence Award. Luis Hurtado, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar.
Arlene Ituriaga, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy, Varsity Basketball, Varsity Volleyball.
Catherine Salas, Honors. Peter Barrios Alvarado, Honors.
Marisol Barreto, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, Varsity Basketball.
Leslie Reyes, Honors.
Alondra Fernandez, Senior Vice President, Honors, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy, Varsity Cheer, Varsity Volleyball, Varsity Softball. Nakaya Cofield, Honors, Golden State Merit Scholar.
Luis Mejia, Honors. Kevin Mancia Arteaga, Honors.
Alejandro Pacheco, honors varsity football. Jacqueline Ramos, honors. Marilyn Ramos Seguenza, honors, Golden State Merit Scholar, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy, varsity cross country, varsity softball.
Los Angeles City Section basketball champion, Kelby Marin, honors, varsity basketball.
Kathy Rojo Flores, honors.
Victoriano Alvarez, honors, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy, varsity cross.
Makar J. Pugh, senior class president, honors, varsity basketball, varsity softball, and varsity cheer. Jay Terrell.
Jezebel Alvarado, Persistence Award. Courtney Anthony. Rodrigo Arevalo Alvarado. Lucia Erasis Merokin, varsity cheer, varsity cross country. Stephanie Ayala. Alejandro Baños Reyes. Corian Barnes, Persistence Award. Juan Bats Cement, Persistence Award. Ismael Bautista.
Franceli Benitez Lopez, varsity volleyball, varsity softball, varsity cross country.
Los Angeles City Section basketball champion, Deshaun Bly, varsity football, varsity basketball.
Marjane Bookman.
Los Angeles City Section basketball champion, Jamon Brooks, varsity basketball.
Hennessy Carbajal Moya. Martin Cardenas, Persistence Award.
Daisy Castro, Varsity Softball, Varsity Cross Country.
Rosemary Chavez, Persistence Award. Joseph Chavez Casillas.
Los Angeles City Section Basketball Champion, Isaiah Cofield. Varsity Football, Varsity Basketball.
Israel Cofield. Christiane Cooper. Luis Cordova Ortiz. Cesar Cristales Hernandez. Victoria Cuevas. Kalise Cunningham. Azario Cush. Alan Diaz.
Reggie Diaz, Seal of Biliteracy, Dymally Drumline.
Kevin Espinosa, Varsity Football.
Stevie Gaines.
Alexander Garcia, Varsity Football.
Jasmine Garcia.
Diego Garcia Negrete, Persistent Awards. Allison Gomez, Persistence Awards. Ashlyn Gomez, Varsity Volleyball. Jose Gomez, Persistence Awards. Stephanie Gomez Bonilla, Los Angeles City Section basketball champion, George Gonzalez. Varsity football, varsity basketball, varsity volleyball. Deani Goodwin. Los Angeles City Section basketball champion, Amari Gray, varsity basketball.
Cesar Guadalupe.
Dahlia Guerrero. Persistence Awards.
Heidi Haros Mesa.
Keani Howard, varsity basketball. Alejandro Isagive, varsity football. Jalen Jackson.
Anthony Javier, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy.
Capricia Johnson. Julian Lopez Chavez, Persistence Awards. Juan Lopez Cruz. Nicholas Luna. Abigail Madrigal. Cadis Madrigal. Mavani Meroquin Salas, varsity cheer, varsity basketball, varsity volleyball. Destiny Martin, varsity cheer, varsity basketball, varsity volleyball. David Martinez, varsity football. Jeffrey Martinez, varsity football. Sergio Martinez. Zulema Martinez Miranda. Hazel Medrano. Marlene Mendoza, Persistence Awards.
Amir Mercer.
Louis Montez, Golden State Merit Scholar.
Ariana Moreno Munoz. Alizé Moss. Angel Novoa. Emerson Orellana Orellana. Josimar Organista. Chrysler Ortega.
Omar Ortiz, Varsity Football.
Darius Parrish.
Nana Pacheco, Varsity Cheer, Varsity Volleyball.
Shalani Patton, Varsity Volleyball, Varsity Basketball.
Catherine Perdomo Anguelo.
Kenya Perez Navarette.
Daniel Perez. Samuel Perez.
Celeste Preciado, Varsity Cross Country, Varsity Track and Field.
Adriana Quintero Rocha.
Axel Quiros, Varsity Football.
Essence Ray, Persistence Award.
Arnolfo Rivas.
Isaias Rodriguez, varsity football.
Tatiana Rodriguez. Catherine Rodriguez Garcia. Alexis Rosas. Roxanne Rosales Estrada. Andreas Solorio. Jonathan Soriano Valencia.
Dulce Torres, varsity softball, LAUSD and California Seal of Biliteracy.
Jonathan Valencia, varsity football.
Jose Valle Ochoa.
Heriberto Vasquez Razo, Golden State Merit Scholar, varsity football.
Lorena Velasquez Zamor.
Viviana Vieira, Persistence Award.
Crystal Villagrana.
Omar Villasana.
Mercy Ward. Andres Zambrano.
At this time, graduates, graduating class of 2020, please stand. Graduates, please move your tassel from right to left. Friends, family, and community, I now present to you Dymally High School's class of 2020, graduating seniors. You have now graduated from high school. Congratulations.
Thank you. Just on another planet.